Dirani with no need to look in the door mirrors quite yet. A 3.3 second lead over Will Stevens, who was 0.7 of a second slower than the Brazilian that time around. 36.5 was Will Stevens' effort. So, no, near enough level pegging, actually. 3.3 seconds becomes 3.2. But Loic Duval applying the pressure now to the rear of Will Stevens' Acura for Konica Minolta and the ARX-05. So that is the next part of this battle that is going to develop, is Brit Will Stevens trying to hold back the very quickly advancing Loic Duval.
Yeah, Loic Duval going out of turn three, very happy to get on the power a bit earlier than Will Stevens. That gave him an advantage. He's now on the right-hand side of the track as they approach turn six. Of course, it's a double left-hander, but he ducks down the inside and seems, as they go onto the banking, to have hasn't got the job done yet. His nose is in front, but the higher line should be the slightly faster line out of the corner. Will Stevens hanging on. He's up near the concrete wall at the top of the track and down near the yellow lines on the inside with a GTD, the Pfaff Motorsport Porsche. They passed either side and no one's lifted off the throttle, but certainly for who's in the Pfaff car. I'll check that in a second. It's Mathieu Jaminet. He must have thought, please, guys, behave. I'm driving as fast as I can. Kept out of their way somehow, but going into and out of the Le Mans chicane, it's still Will Stevens in second place. Just 3 seconds down on race leader Pipo Durán. But Loic Duval is having fun, but he wants that place, and I think he's going to get it at this rate.
That was very entertaining indeed to see two expert sports car racers with Loic Duval a decision to make. Do I keep the throttle in, or do I just blend out of it so I can get safely round the number 9 Pfaff car? And down into turn one, out in the dusty conditions almost, certainly the marbles there at turn one for Loic Duval. He still found good speed off the corner though in the Cadillac, and it was fascinating to me that to observe the drag race through Speedway's turns one and two. The Acura looked like it had the edge, and now the Cadillac is coming back into its own on the infield, but only the outside line shown for Loic Duval through the kink. So good driving and good positioning of the car from Will Stevens, not allowing the 5 car the crucial inside line through that sequence of tight and twisty corners on the infield. Again, Will Stevens edging the 5 to the outside line, so Loic Duval is going to have to do it the hard way if he's going to get through, although the outside-inside trick should work this time with the Frenchman, and he's passed.
It just seemed to my eye that, particularly on the infield, that Loic Duval had a bit more grip in the number 5 JDC Miller Motorsports Cadillac. He's made it stick, but again, taking the higher line is slightly faster for Will Stevens, so he's half a car length behind. He's now quarter of a car length. His nose is in front. They go past the GTD car, but what comes next? The Le Mans chicane. You've got to go left and right, so Will Stevens has to back out of it. Second place now firmly in the hands of Loic Duval, but again, just at the wrong moment, they find another GTD class car, and that allows a slight lift for Loic Duval. And Will Stevens has got a bit more pace coming out of the chicane and accelerating around the banking. Of course, Johnny, here you accelerate for a very, very long time. They're side by side as they're going to take the left-hand kink onto the start-finish straight.
Straight line speed is all with the Acura here, because at times when it looks dead and buried in third position, it comes back again on the high line to Loic Duval. Now that the Cadillac, though, will lead this time onto the infield, I can see that the Cadillac will start to stretch its legs, because it is really good out of the slowest speed horseshoes, the Western Horseshoe first of all. Just has to compromise its exit very slightly because of the WeatherTech Mercedes, or is that the 57 car? I'm struggling to tell the difference between those two in the darkness.
I think it's the WeatherTech car with the two. Yes, it is.
You're right. And that car then sensibly staying to the outside line, being driven by Patrick Assenheimer in the number 15 car. A number of times taking NLS victories in the last few years. Patrick Assenheimer, a real expert around the Nürburgring Nordschleife, but I think has run here at least once before too, on a very different racetrack.
Yeah, just to explain, NLS stands for Nürburgring Langstrecken Series, and just to point out what that might mean, it's long-distance races. They have 8 of them each year, and traditionally they've been 3 hours, occasionally with a 4-hour and a 6-hour, but this year they're going to have double up, and there's going to be 12 hours of racing in one of those. And